Get ready to match the stars. Bill Anderson, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Riley, David Gabor, Richard Dawson, and Betty White as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 77. And now here's the star of the Match Game 77, Gene Rivers!
Thank you, my dear. Daniel, how are you?
Thank you for joining us. I greet you one and all.
Nice to be greeted. I wish all our Aries friends happy, happy. You know.
It's Aquarius over with.
Oh, yeah.
Because I'm an Aquarius, and yes. I had a birthday for days.
What are you?
I'm a Scorpio.
You're a Scorpio.
Is that good?
Yeah. Oh, it's not only good. Bill Anderson has a new album out called Scorpio, and he dedicated it to my birth sign.
I think wasn't that nice?
What a sneaky plug. But
oh, that's yeah.
Are you really a Scorpio?
Yeah.
What's your birthday?
20th of November.
Yeah, mine's the 1st. Hey.
Excuse me. Well, we got that over with.
Oh, yeah. All right. Let's move on now. What do you say? Say hello to Kathy Norcup and Donna Saylor. Ladies. Kathy is our current champ. She's won one game. She has $200 to her credit, and she is naturally hoping for more, isn't she?
Oh, yes, she is.
And she's going to be challenged now by Donna Saylor. We just met her as the time expired last time, and we found out she was from where?
Cucamonga.
She has three children, right?
Mm-hmm.
And she works in a bank.
Mm-hmm. Savings and loan.
Mm-hmm. That's
right.
Different.
Right.
All right. If you're all set, Donna, we'll begin right after we do a little business with a man. All right, ladies, we'll begin now by pushing this button. Ask Donna Saylor to make a selection here.
B, please.
Donnie, 1B. You'll be sorry. No, I have no idea what they are. Jacques Cousteau. You know who she is. Oh, is he? Yeah. Okay, you know who he is. Jacques Cousteau hired a new first mate who's a practical joker.
Ho, ho, ho.
But Jacques fired him because he put a piranha in Jacques' blank. Now, I know you came along for some laughs here, but you can't just sit there and laugh at the things. You got to write something now, too, Bill. Jacques Cousteau.
No, that's
in
job.
The blank.
Oh, that's very
good. That's our job. Otherwise, they wouldn't need us if they gave us the whole thing.
Are we allowed to tell Charles what a piranha is?
A piranha is a fish, carnivorous. Well, carnivorous. If there are no men around,
plants?
They got to eat something else, don't
What's
they?
What's those plants?
What's that?
What are the plants that
the
he
plants?
People?
That's a fern.
I don't know what they're called, but they're plant
things. Gene.
What?
I have a message for all those who are staying home from school today.
Yes. Happy hooking.
Happy what? I just don't want to leave out any of our friends.
Thank you very much. That's very kind of you.
Happy what?
Donna,
happy
are you ready?
Happy
well, I'm not. Yes, here I am. Jacques Cousteau. Now, you know about Jacques Cousteau. He's a famous, you know who he is. He hired a new first mate, and the first mate was a practical joker. But Jacques fired him because he put a piranha in Jacques' blank.
Swimming trunks.
Swimming trunks. Okay. Well.
Ooh, that's smart.
Okay. Swimming trunks isn't bad. That would be very uncomfortable. I mean, it's not a bad answer because it would be uncomfortable. That's all I
And dangerous.
Idea. Yes.
And make them talk in a honey voice.
What do you say here?
I said I thought he wore a rubber suit.
Yeah, now that's interesting because swimming trunks and rubber suits are really not the same thing. I was going to point that out to you, Donna, but you said swimming trunks.
I think you did. You just pointed it out rather beautifully.
Thank you.
I thought you pointed it out brilliantly. Did they boo just on spec, or did
no,
they?
No, you know what happens. They watch this program at home, and they hear an occasional boo, and then they come here and they think they're expected to boo. You are not expected to boo. Only boo when you really hear a rotten answer.
Are they
There hasn't been an answer yet. You're not supposed to boo until you hear an answer.
Darling, they are very hostile.
They are.
Everybody to the psychiatrist's couch. Show us your answer.
Okay. I said rubber suit just like Bill Anderson.
Okay.
No, boo, it's good.
Now listen.
Maybe just smile.
You didn't like swim trunks. You don't like rubber suit. What do you want?
Jockey shorts.
Jockey shorts. Okay. Jockey. Yeah, jockey. I think I'm getting it now. There.
Do you have an eraser?
Yeah. How about bunk bed?
Bunk bed.
Bunk bed.
It's not bad.
That
I can see
bad.
Where your heads are at now. Because Jacques fired him because he put a piranha in Jacques' jockey shorts, is what they have in mind.
Darling.
Of course, Donna Saylor said swimming trunks. What do you say?
I mean, a piranha eats you up altogether. A jockey short would hurt a lot. I put him in a vet suit.
In a vet suit. Okay.
Is that a veterinarian suit?
No,
a
vet
suit. But you put on when you go under the water.
That's
why
right.
Why do they call it wet suit and blue rubber?
Show the suit again.
The thing you put on.
Oh, yes, of course.
All the way down.
All the way down.
One more time. One more time.
Okay, that's enough. We got the idea.
Oh, a wet suit.
A wet suit. Yeah.
Well, what are you going to tell us?
Well, I tell you, this is going to take a little explaining because, you know, on board ship, it is called, the John is called the head. And I just thought perhaps, in case anybody...
You're going to put a piranha in Jacques's head. That's right. You really are au courant, aren't you?
Well, that too.
Yes. That too. You want A or B? You want A? Okay, you got A. That's it. All right, my dear. Here we go. The inventor of the bionic woman said... You know how when you buy a car, you get a spare tire?
You do.
Yes. You get a spare tire when you buy a car. He says, well, when I invented the bionic woman, I gave her a spare blank. Oh, we're rolling along. I love these. Oh, this is a terrific one.
Yep.
You know, Betty White has a spare tire, and she doesn't even own a car.
That was mean. I love you.
I only put up with that because she is the Dowager Queen.
Yes.
What did you say?
She said she puts up with you because you're the Dowager Queen. And you sit up there.
We know we're the Dowager Queen. I'm Vince by Gamer.
Come on, now there's a very good one and a very simple one. Look, Ava's finished already.
Not here. Very well, though.
Really?
Yeah.
Now, don't look.
That's good. Right.
You're not allowed to pee.
Yes,
are you
I'm It's my job.
Well, you want to look, look.
All right. Okay, there
you
it
like
is.
It? I'm getting
I love it.
Charge.
Yeah. Kathy, are you ready?
Oh, wait a minute.
Oh, dear me. Oh.
I'm sorry, sweetheart.
Okay, now, the inventor of the bionic woman said, you know how when you buy a car, you get a spare tire? Well, when I invented the bionic woman, I gave her a spare blank.
Breast and or boob?
Boob. Okay. What do you say, Bill?
I want to say a word about this group in here.
Yeah, say a word about this group.
Let me tell you what, you're a bunch of front runners. Now, if I get the answer right, you're going to say, yay, and a while ago you were booing. I don't like front runners. Well, they're going to boo anyway.
Even though there's a match, they're going to boo, huh?
I said boob tube, is that right?
You give her a spare boob tube.
Bionic,
oh, that's right. Oh, yeah, okay. I get it. Very clever. Boob tube.
You know, like bionic woman?
I'll explain it later in my dressing room. Yeah.
You know, there's been an error here because, as you can see from the first part of my... I said a pair of,
a
right?
pair of.
Now, I got so nervous, you see, because you hurried me along and my little brain wasn't working too well, that I said buns, but I actually meant the other end.
Oh, well, I'm sorry. What it says here is what we have to go with.
Oh, all right.
Okay. Yes.
I'm getting so trashy, I can't stand myself.
Those curls make her look so virginal, too.
Yes.
Fortunately, I'm nearsighted. Now, I said like Boo, Baza.
Boob.
And he keeps them, she keeps them in their trunk.
It keeps a spare boob in the trunk, yeah. Okay, well, he says that when I invented the bionic woman, I gave her a spare boob. What do you say, Ava?
Well, she got two very good ones, so I thought they would have given her a third boobs.
A singular.
Can you see that?
So that don't make fun of that. That's the singular.
I speak.
Yes.
A pair of boobs or one bob.
Darling, I speak four languages and I do them all
caca. Phonetically. Yes.
Caca, yes. You know, mixed up.
And none of them well.
Listen. I gotta save this one. That's it. I'm going home saying to my wife, Helen, you won't believe this. But watch this. What do you think that means, huh? Buffalo Bob was on the show, you know? Buffalo Boob there. Now listen, I gave her a spare what?
Either way you spell it, boob.
There it is. That's four for you. Now, if you make it five, it'll be an odd number.
You walk like this?
Yes.
Now, be serious here.
Betty.
We've
got to
be serious, because you won't believe I did start to write that, as you can see by the... But I thought it didn't work on the last answer, but I thought maybe head would work on this answer.
Oh, you didn't.
I know.
Give her a spare head. Okay, there's round one, 4-0 favor the champ, and now round two coming up after this. Hello there. Now, round two coming up. Donna, you may have A or B.
B, please.
Thank you. You got to go to work. What? You change your mind?
No.
A, B.
Yes.
All right. Everybody plays because she didn't match anybody in the first round. Listen carefully now.
Okay.
Susan said, I'm Congressman Smith's confidential secretary. I do all my work under blank. apparently you all understood it. Did you understand it, Charles?
No. What does he understand of life and living?
I love that sweater.
Thank you.
Okay, here we go. Donna Saylor. Susan said, I'm Congressman Smith's confidential secretary. I do all my work under blank.
Cover.
Undercover. Done? Yeah. And not as weird as I thought they were. Give a good answer like that, they respond to it. Bill, what do you say?
I say I want to hear them respond again, because I said cover!
Okay, Donnie, you got one there. What do you say to that?
This may be a match. Covers.
Oh, yes, of course. Undercover. Two for you, Donna. Charles?
Covers.
Covers, all right. Ava, Susan said, I'm Congressman Smith's confidential secretary. I do all my work under...
Oh, I'm in big trouble. You can start booing. It means the same thing, but I said it differently. I said in bed. I mean...
Well, wait a minute.
It's the same thing, girl.
You have to hear it to understand it.
You've got to be in bed to have a cover. And I mean, she's in bed, and then they... I mean, what the heck?
Under in bed.
Under. Now, let me just give it to you one more time here. I do all my work under in bed.
I like it. Now you've read it that way.
That's right. Could we put music to it?
Yeah, you cut the middleman.
Right.
It's excellent.
I mean,
there it is.
Yes. Don't do that.
Yes.
But, how are you?
Cover.
Cover. High score, 4-4. Another one. Okay. There we are in the middle of round two. Score is 5-4. And you got a shot at it. We'll see what happens right after we see about this. Here we go. Ready?
Set.
Kathy. Now, you've matched four. There are two remaining, Brett and Betty.
B&B.
B&B. And what you have to do...
Because we were so smart.
Because your name doesn't start with B.
Well, but you matched her in the previous question, you see, so you lay out this time.
Oh, great.
You understand
we'll
what that means.
Just hold
hands. Yeah, I am right. Smashing.
Yes. Have a picnic on your shirt.
Okay.
The Dolly Sister.
This is just for the Dolly Sisters. What?
I have a picnic on your shirt.
Well, it makes a change from lipstick on your collar. Let's go.
The insurance company fired Dumb Donald, the salesman, because he tried to sell life insurance to a blank. The insurance company fired Dumb Donald, the salesman, because he tried to sell life insurance to a blank.
Doesn't Ava go out? She looking home in a little gingham shirt.
Yeah, simple little gingham shirt.
Get the load.
Are you ready, Kathy? One to tie and two to win. The insurance company fired Dumb Donald, the salesman, because he tried to sell life insurance to a...
dead person.
A dead person.
Okay.
One corpse will tie the score. May we
One
see it?
One corpse will tie the score. The score?
Show it.
Corpestata.
There it is. That's one tie score. Another cadaver will win the game for her.
I think we may have to have a meeting.
What have
a
we got?
A mummy.
A mummy is
That's
a dead person.
That's a dead person.
As she said, dead person. That's a mummy. And there we go.
Come on now, Kathy. Congratulations.
Okay, don't go away now. Donna, it was a pleasure to meet you, my dear.
I've had a lovely time.
I'm very happy about that. We've got lots of gifts coming your way. Donna Saylor, goodbye, my dear. Bye. Now, let's see, Kathy, you're up to $300. We're going to have another shot at the big money here. Here it is. We polled a recent studio audience, and we got their best response to this. Janice Blank. $500, if you got that answer they gave most frequently. For matching their second most popular answer, you get $250. And for matching the third, you get $100. And whom do you call on?
Richard.
Janice Page.
All right.
Nice actress. The little mention.
Brett. Janis Joplin.
They're all so cute.
Don't do that. I have no idea.
Ava? Yes, you got an answer.
No, I haven't.
Wait a minute. Something may come to you, dear.
Janice Gabor.
No.
Something may come to you. You never can tell.
Just think about it.
Is anything coming to her yet?
It didn't come to me.
Oh, listen.
I wish I could hear that.
That's enough of that. Come
Janice
on now.
Rule.
Janice Rule.
Fantastic. Oh.
All right. You want Janice Rule?
Janice Ian.
Janice Page or Janice Joplin?
Janice Joplin.
Or one of your own.
Ian. No more of that. Joplin.
Joplin it is. Let's find out if it's up there. May we see the $100 response, if you please, sir. Janice Lind. Now, let's slide up a notch and reveal the next one. Janice Page.
Oh, I'm glad I mentioned
All right,
her,
last chance for Janice Joplin. Go.
Be there.
Yeah. Oh, good girl. Now you're up to $800. Get a play for 10 times that amount or $5,000. Whom do you call on?
Richard, please.
Okay, Richard, get ready to write. You stand on the blue fuzzy carpet there, and here we go. Worth $5,000. Good luck to you. Blank ground. G-R-O-U-N-D. Blank ground. He's finished. What answer would you give us to match his and collect that money? Blank ground.
Burial ground.
Burial ground.
What do they know?
I don't know. Richard, what do you say?
Underground.
Underground.
Well, that's very good.
No.
Have to be
the rule is it has to be an exact match. I was thinking of background. Well, now, listen, Kathy Norcutt. What's that? Playground. That's another one here.
Many.
What do you want to do here? You want to go on here? Yeah. All right. Are you ready to meet another player? So are we. Here comes Gene Jansen. Now, those two ladies know each other, and they greet each other, and we greet you, and wish you the best of luck, and ask you to tell us the Gene Jansen story.
All right, I'm from Orange County.
Yes.
I'm 21 and single.
Call it. It's my show. Yes.
I work as a cocktail waitress down in Newport Beach.
I'll be there right after the show.
Okay. And I just got accepted for being a flight attendant.
So good.
I'm waiting for that.
Listen, when is your voice going to change?
Oh,
you
it's
have
not
a
that
beautiful
low.
Voice.
Don't you have a marvelous
yeah.
voice?
Yep, marvelous.
Thank you.
Say, 4 score and 7 years ago,
4 years ago.
Keep on going. I just love the sound of your voice.
Don't,
I don't know the
Now say your phone number.
Yes. And now we've got to stop right here and do a little business with America, so pay attention if you please. Join us next time for Match Game 77. I'm Gene Rayburn. Goodbye. Thank you.